occupy some strength of the K-12 music and art curriculum. One is, as already mentioned by the previous group, the number one strength is student-centered. Okay, so no further explanation as to that. Holistic development. So we were able to discuss what spelling are we going to use. Is it the holistic with a W or a holistic with an H? So it's not actually a debatable issue anymore. But we want our student to develop holistically. Okay? We consider also one of the strengths of the music and art conceptual framework that it is a performance-based learning. Gone are the days that we will give our students paper and pencil assessment in as much as we do not include MAPE in the National Achievement Test. Right? So what's the use of giving them paper and pencil test? We will just be wasting papers. Eh, medyo environment friendly tayo. So we just use our saliva. Okay? We just give them instructions, we give them clear instructions, and give them a concrete evidence of whatever skills that has been developed in this particular learning area. Integrative approach, we were able to see that there are integration in as much as we integrate concepts from different learning areas. Not only in the four components of MAPE, but we also include other key concepts and key learnings from other subject area. Development of multiple intelligences. No? Meron tayong, ilan na ba ang MI natin ngayon? 9 na. So, kung ano man yung pang-sham, tanongin natin yung mga taga-bureau kung ano yung pang-sham. Basta, yung music and art, nandoon ng musical skill, nandoon ng artistic or spatial skill, nandurot sa dance, nandurot na yung kinesthetic, and all other multiple intelligences, nandurot magsisimula sa akin, sa subject natin. Bakit naman natin sa ibang learning area yan? Kayo nagsabi niyan, hindi ako ha? Spiral progression. Okay. Parang nadagdag yung spiral progression, no? Tsaka doon. Spiral progression, we consider it a strength and at the same time, a weakness. Okay. Spiral progression because we see that doon sa content, nagsimula tayo from the basic, from grade, from the kinder, hanggang sa grade 12. However, yung another point naman ng weakness niya, we see that in grade 8 in particular, there's no spiral progression. Kasi we will just expose our students in the culture of music and art of different Asian countries. But what particular skill are we developing from our students when we teach this, the music and arts of different countries? That is why we include here spiral progression as one of the weaknesses of this particular of K-12. Philippine art. Ano na nga ba yung Philippine art?
First year.
Ayan. Grade 7. Parang nalimutan ko na.
Na? Asian art kasi dapat ang grade 8, sir.
Oo, Asian art.
Kabagyan?
Asian art dapat.
I forgot what we have discussed with the four group a while ago.
Yung grade 8 kasi it's about Asian art, pero yung nakalagay sa grade 8, it's Philippine art.
Ah, yeah. It's a conceptual framework.
Baka type of error.
Yeah, in the statement of, is it in the conceptual framework or in the... Okay, in the conceptual framework states there that it is only Philippine art that will include will be discussed and that will be included in the discussion of that we will our students will be exposed in the Philippine art. But we did not state there that they will also be exposed or they will also be learning some music of Asian countries. Okay. Siguro pwede lang natin idagdag yun. Siguro just a suggestion. Pero pwede natin idagdag doon sa framework ng ating, sa statement ng ating conceptual framework. Another weaknesses is, one of the weaknesses also is that what is our basis of considering the Asian countries is that our, is that what we have discussed?
Where is the references of the Asian countries?
Ah, okay. Where
there are
is
books from the Philippines, but there are no books used for this specific purpose.
Ah, okay. So, naintindihan niyo po. Okay. Meron po kayong tanong? Wala. So, that's 3.5 minutes of the presentation. Thank you.